Hi, I'm Janet Anderson, and I am a team member of S2 Core, but I'm also a therapist and I run a mental health clinic, and this is my office. I'm here at my mental health clinic. And today what I want to talk about, since the holidays are coming, is how to cope with grief during the holidays. If we are not coping with grief during the holidays, we will be definitely stressed during this time of year, but we'll also be looking forward to things. We'll be excited and feeling positive about spending time with our family or friends and doing all of the holiday things. But if you're grieving during the holiday season, this experience is going to be definitely different this year. There are three things that I would like to share with you on how to cope during the holidays. But first, I want to give a little information about the grief process. Grieving can happen anytime there's a major transition in your life. I like to think about it as they become checkpoints. Was that before or after the divorce? Was that before or after my grandfather passed away? Was that before or after we moved? It becomes a checkpoint in our life that references before or after. Any of those kind of events, big or small, could make you go into the grieving process. And then that leads me to when you are grieving during the holidays, it's especially important to make sure that you're coping. And it's a little different than when you're grieving throughout the rest of the year. So one of the first things you can do to help you cope during the holidays with grief is make sure that you give yourself permission to not do everything that you have done in past holiday seasons. You have my permission to say no. You do not have to do all of the rituals, all the traditions. You pick the ones that are important to you, and all of the other extra holiday stuff, you don't need to do that. You have my permission to slow down. I want you to take time to relax and take care of yourself, which leads to the second one. It is so important that you are taking care of yourself, and there are three basic ways when you're grieving that you have to take care of yourself. Because when you are grieving, it's like everything just kind of slows down because it's something that we experience from the inside. It's not something that is happening to us. It's coming from within. The other little tidbit of information is grieving is not something that you can think your way through. You can't think yourself out of it. It is something that our body has a natural system. It needs to feel its way through the grief process. So number two, the things that you need to do to take care of yourself is make sure that you are eating healthy, make sure that you are sleeping, and make sure that you're exercising. Now, I'm not talking about going to spin class for an hour and sweating a ton. It could be as simple as walking around the block for 2 minutes. So eating, sleeping, and exercising. And then the third one has to do with your feelings. You need to allow yourself to naturally heal, which means you have to feel your way through this. And therefore, you need to allow your feelings to be present. You need to honor them for what they are and allow them to wash over you. And more specifically, I want to talk about allowing your body to weep. That's number three. I need you to allow your body to cry and weep whenever it needs to do it. That might mean that you're in the middle of the mall and all of a sudden you're crying. That's fine, and that's totally normal. Allow that to weep and move through you. The way that I describe tears and weeping are they are the words that we do not have in the dictionary to help us describe what we're going through. How do we describe and define what it feels like to lose a child or to lose a loved one? We don't have words in the dictionary for that. We have our tears. And so when we are weeping, we are releasing as if we are talking out those words to help us heal. So it's so important to make sure that you take time to do that. So again, the three things that are important to help you grieve during the holiday seasons are: one, making sure that you slow down and you do not have to do all the obligations that you've done in the past. Two is making sure that you're taking care of yourself, sleeping, eating, and exercising. And three, making sure that you're allowing your feelings to be there, specifically sadness and weeping. I'm sorry if you are going through grief during the holiday season or you know someone who is. I wish that this holiday season be healing for you, and many blessings. I hope that you have found this information helpful. If you would like to receive more mini videos and information like this sent directly to your email, I would be willing to do that for you. There are three ways that you can enroll. You can go to janetandersoncounseling.com and email me through that website. You could go to solutionstobreakthemold.com and email me through that website. Or you can find us on Facebook at Anderson Health and Wellness, and you can private message me there. The information that I would need is your name, number, and your email, and I'll make sure to get you on the email list.